Ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Wall.
Hour number three for a Friday afternoon. Good to have you with us. Our brand new time, this is when it gets really interesting in the day, that breaking news is happening. And so this new noon to three time slot is absolutely perfect for us. Don't forget, Wayne Allyn Root coming up 3 o'clock. Joining us now, I'm very happy to have him on again. He is a candidate for the U.S. Senate. He is the former attorney general. Good guy all around. He is Adam Laxalt, and he joins us. Adam, how's life been on the campaign trail?
Oh, things going great. You know, we're just charging around the state and excited to see all the enthusiasm out there. And look, people are ready to take back Nevada is the bottom line. And people are upset as possible with everything we're seeing out there in our country and what the Biden administration, with the help of Senator Catherine Cortez Masto, they're destroying everything that we believe in. And I think people are ready to rise up and really make their voices heard at the ballot box.
Adam, I know that you've had, and we've talked about in recent conversations, all of the endorsements nationally that you've gotten from no less than a former president, and it's been interesting to look at how your campaign has reached out to folks. Now I see just this week, and you correct me if I'm wrong, Gun Owners of America, Freedom Works, they've all endorsed you. What is going on? It's almost as if your campaign is really catching fire.
Well, look, people want a conservative that is going to fight for them, and I've been the person that has been virtually standing alone as a conservative in this state fighting for our values. And you know, a lot of these people we've worked with, a lot of these groups know that we've been allies, and we've been able to be counted on, you know, whether it was the NRA or Gun Owners of America. You know, no one has fought harder for the Second Amendment in this state than I did as Attorney General. We're involved in some really important lawsuits, both in San Francisco and San Diego, trying to fight for the ability for people to actually have their concealed carry and leave their homes, something that is at the Supreme Court right now. In fact, a really, really landmark case for us. For your listeners, you know, we all know the Heller case that you know, really laid down the marker that this is a constitutional right that can't be infringed. But a lot of these courts have decided that they're just going to kind of cut it down as best they can. And let's really hope that the Supreme Court says that governments, we do not need to ask permission from a bureaucrat or from government to be able to have a concealed carry outside of our home. If that's the regime, we all know how that's going to go down. And we all know that people aren't going to be able to defend themselves. And so I'm optimistic about what we heard at the Supreme Court. And I think we could have a really landmark case that makes it clear to blue states like Nevada that they can't infringe on these rights.
I want to ask you about an issue that's definitely going to come up when you become a United States senator, and that is border security and how Democrats just are failing to secure it. And in fact, when you look at the numbers are getting worse. They're not getting any better.
You know, and they sit up there in press conferences, and they just deny it. We all know the media is the mouthpiece of the left, and they refuse to cover this. They only cover issues that they think are going to help Democrats get elected. They won't cover such a massive issue for our country. What is more important than nationhood? What is more important than our borders and that we are a country that means something and citizenship means something? I could tell you, someone that put on a uniform and served in Iraq, we're doing that because we believe in a nation. We are defending what it means to be an American citizen. And if the left gets their way, they continue to dilute what it means to be America, what it means to be an American citizen. And they know what they're doing. They're trying to convert us into some sort of world order with no borders. And it would destroy the very fabric of what made this country so great.
I want to ask you about some breaking news today. Another bad jobs report for the Biden administration, and yet the president came out. He looked and sounded feeble and really sick today at the White House, but he came out and tried to put lipstick on the pig. What do you think of today's 210,000 job report that disappointed all the experts?
Yeah, well, as I'm sure your listeners know, I mean, it fell well short of the already low expectations for job growth, and we're living it here. Jobs are simply not growing in this state, and you have Senator Catherine Cortez Masto that is trying to run as the jobs senator. She has the audacity to try to pretend like she's the one that's been delivering jobs here in Nevada. I wouldn't be running on that if my state was 50 out of 50 on unemployment. And that's where we are right now. And we plan on prosecuting that case. And they act like their policies have nothing to do with this. But everybody knows that the Biden administration has absolutely destroyed our economy. They've increased inflation, made everything incredibly unaffordable. And, you know, they can do all the spin they want with all the help of the media. But there's no escaping the facts and the reality that our country is going in the wrong direction. And everybody remembers what was going on just a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, when we had the greatest economy this state has ever had.
Another issue that I know you're going to be dealing with as a United States senator, and that's critical race theory. Can you give me your stance on that? I have not had a chance to hear your message on critical race theory.
Look, we actually did a town hall about six, seven weeks ago, long before a critical race theory became the epicenter of that Virginia governor's race. I was so encouraged to see so many parents that showed up and they were willing to fight for our kids and make sure these kinds of things are not being put in our schools. And look, I got to say, I have some optimism. I know all of us feel pretty pessimistic about the future of our country, and we look around and we feel like we're losing a lot of these battles. But on the critical race theory front, most people never even heard of it a year ago. And I think now most people are aware of it. We continue to raise the noise on it so that parents are paying attention. And there was a lot of backtracking going on. You know, the state of Florida, just their school board just revoked the charter that connects to the national school board. Washoe County did that in northern Nevada. I encourage the state and Clark County and all other counties to take that same vote. But we seem to be on the march on this issue because no one is really wanting to sign up for a system where we're teaching our children to hate each other, to be divided by race, to apologize for, you know, perhaps generations of upbringing. This is not the America that we all love and know. These aren't the values that made our country the place that everyone wants to have the American dream in. And so I think it's a good ray of optimism that when we speak about these issues and we speak boldly and courageously, you know, we can fight back and we can make a difference.
You are in the midst of a statewide tour, the Laxalt for the U.S. Senate, and you're going to have a great event tomorrow right here in Las Vegas. Kellyanne Conway and you, Adam Laxalt, together at Stoney's. Can you talk a little bit about how this relationship with Kellyanne Conway came about?
Yeah, you know, fortunately I was able to meet her many, many years ago. She's been one of the conservative warriors for a very, very long time. And she was that well before she became the head of Trump's campaign and helped him win in 2016. And obviously she went into the White House as a senior advisor. And we actually had her to the Basque Fry as one of our keynote speakers at our big annual events. And so she's been a friend, someone that I can call for advice, and someone that I've worked with in the past. And obviously she cares about this race. She knows that this is part of one of the one or two races that help us win back the United States Senate. She knows I'm a proven, trusted conservative. Obviously, she knows that I'm endorsed by the president, her former boss. And so, yeah, we're having an America First rally on Saturday. In fact, we've got hundreds and hundreds of people coming. And this is important. We need to excite our folks, get our people motivated, and make sure they're ready to turn out at all-time highs take back this state.
You've traveled to all 17 counties in this state, and I want to ask you, I know you give a good speech, but you also are a very good listener, and I want to ask you, what is the two, maybe three issues that you're hearing about mostly from folks in our state, whether it's up north or down south here or somewhere in between?
Well, let me just say, you know, you had that incredibly important Virginia win. And I think that gave people confidence that we still have a silent majority in this country that's ready to rise up and fight back against the left. But after that race, you saw a lot of prognosticators try to pick out the one or two issue that they thought made that race. And I remind them that, you know, New Jersey went just as red as Virginia. And the reason I say that is because when I speak to voters in any part of the state, and in any walk of life, they have everything on top of their minds. They know America's heading in the wrong direction. They are fearful of the left's advance in our popular culture. They are fearful of cancel culture and that they can't speak out. And so, you know, you're going to see the prognosticators always want to put it on inflation or one thing or the other. But one thing that I find that unique this time, unlike, you know, maybe in the Obama era where it was all about the Constitution and what we did to fight back against Obama's overreach of the Constitution, now they list it all, you know. They know the economy is terrible. They know the border is causing us great harm, increasing drugs, increasing human trafficking. They also know that, you know, we can't rely on our ruling elites in Washington to be truthful, that spin is nonstop, whether it's through COVID or whether it's, you know, we just went through both the Rittenhouse trial and then the Waukesha massacre. And, you know, this guy, who was a serial criminal with ties to Nevada, by the way, who should have not been released on bail, the guy mows down a bunch of people, kills innocent people and children. What does the media do? It disappears. They don't want to cover that story. And I think these things just roll off of people's tongues because they're following it, they're paying attention. That is a great sign for us, Kevin. That is a great sign that people are absolutely dialed in to what is going on, and I think we're going to see it next November in the polls.
Change is definitely coming. One more time in our final 30 seconds, the big event that's coming up tomorrow at Stoney's. How can people find out more about it? And is it a free event? Is there a price?
It's a free event. You can go to adamlaxalt.com/event. It's 2 p.m. at Stoney's. It's going to be a great crowd. Kellyanne Conway is one of the best. She's going to be awesome. Obviously going to hear from me. And, you know, we're going to do a lot of what we just did just now, Kevin. We're going to talk about what's going on and how we think we can take back America.
Adam,
see you there.
Adam, I will see you tomorrow. Thank you so much. I really appreciate you joining us today. You have yourself a great rest of your afternoon and safe travels, okay?
All right. Beautiful weather. That's for sure.
Gotta love it. Adam Laxalt, candidate for U.S. Senate and former Attorney General, joining us as we continue right here on AM 670 KMZQ.